missions, going into the world, is hardwired into God's story in the Bible. It's not just the Great Commission, go into all the world, but it is what God has been doing. Just the short version, right? When God says to Abraham in Genesis 12 that through you all the nations of the earth are going to be blessed, the Great Commission, going into all the world, making disciples of all the nations, that is the blessing to the nations. It's the gospel of Jesus Christ is how all the nations of the earth are blessed through the promise to Abraham. And I think everybody going out into missions, whether it's medical or not, needs to understand and lay hold of and live that story that needs to be our story.
As doctors, we get to have a unique role in God's purpose of redeeming the world right now. I think that our role helps us to have a tangible way and a front seat, if you will, for God's redemption breaking through. The world was created good and the world is now fallen, but he has said, I am making everything new. And that doesn't just mean that everything will someday be made new, but even now he is in the process of bringing that redemption to bear in our lives and in the world.
Lamine Sana, the one great African theologian, he passed now, said that Christianity, because of the translation of God's word, has transformed villages, cities, health, and everything. AIDS, it was Uganda that broke through with AIDS, abstinence. They started teaching that. Up to today, I met the guy that started this radio station, bringing in Christian value, bringing in Christian principles. He has medicine. I don't care whether you are Muslims, Buddhists, atheists, animists, anyone can come and receive it. So I would say that's the difference.
I was involved in the early days of the AIDS crisis in Uganda, East Africa, and we had no cure for AIDS. And as you were caring for people who were dying from AIDS, then the only thing that we really had to offer was the gift of salvation. And the only way to prevent AIDS was to talk about God's order of creation and what he intended for us in our lives, and the need to be abstinent if you were not married, and if you were married, to be faithful in marriage, and working through scriptures. We had a little booklet called God's Word, and medical science gives answers to questions related to AIDS. And we use that throughout the country in both Catholic and Protestant churches. And so many people came to us and said, you know, if I hadn't gotten sick or my family member hadn't gotten sick, I would never have had the opportunity to hear about the gospel in that way, and that Jesus cares for us and our loved ones, and we can change our behavior and we can prevent AIDS.
We have several medical students who have become Christians while working with us, even one Muslim student. Some other non-Christian students will say that they really developed a sense of what it means to be a Christian while working at the hospital with us.
My background is as a general surgeon. But we decided early on that we basically tried to reverse engineer healthcare missions, in that we try to think about, okay, what's the end result we want, which is disciples in every ethne, disciples in every nation, and how do we best get to that through health strategies and through healthcare. And so we came to the conclusion that me doing surgery all day, every day, probably wasn't the most effective way to do that, actually. And so we took a different approach of more health education. I do some relational primary care in homes, but it's usually kind of relational lines that are offshoots from the health education that we do.
We go into these villages, not demeaning, you know, like the African traditional religion. Is it true, not true? No, we are concerned about the hearts and the health of these people. If we can meet these people, love them as God loves them, the Great Commission can easily be fulfilled.
And the church is described as a body. And there are many parts to this body, but when one part of the body suffers, the whole body suffers. And for me, it was really important to not just to use medicine as a way to reach unreached people groups with the gospel, but to also relieve suffering for our Christian brothers and sisters.
You know, I think the call to missions is a call for everyone to kind of get on board with whatever skill set they have. And here's the other thing. I think that people in the medical provision, I think people in the medical professions, honestly, they have opportunities that a lot of other people don't have. They have opportunities to go to places where a lot of people couldn't go if they weren't a medical profession. And now here's the thing though, I think that Christian medical missions folks need to go into those situations realizing that their position there could be compromised by their sharing of the gospel and not letting that stop them.
Some of the neediest and poorest places where the quality of life is most difficult are also the most unreached places. And so often that just sets us up for good strategies to meet real needs and bring the gospel to places where it hasn't been. But there are parts of the world, specifically parts of the Arabian Peninsula and other places where there's not abject poverty associated with lostness. And those are places where increasingly people who have specialty Western training can go without having to raise support, even can go as employed physicians in some of these countries and work in really honestly higher tech settings where you can use all the tools that you're trained with and you can do your job and get paid to do your job while living in a culture where you can also be a missionary.
I remember one year our president for the mission that I worked with challenged each one of us. I want you this year, whatever year it was, I want you this year in whatever your ministry is, every aspect, how can you add one tool of evangelism? How can you add one tool and or discipleship into what you are doing? What one new tool? And that, it just really changed my thinking to get me back to keeping the main thing the main thing. As I was fixing broken bones, taking out ruptured appendices and so forth, that I already had a deep sense that I want to pray with patients, but what other thing could I add that would draw attention to the gospel and to the great physician?
Eternal life in him by faith. There's no reason that message, and it is a message, can't be brought by people who are trained as medical professionals. Who understand that they're going in as medical professionals, but you know they are going in with medical professionals who are there to heal, they're there to relieve, they're there to teach and train if possible, but they're also people with a message, right? And that they're showing by what they're doing there and why they're there, what that message is. It's their way of expressing the truth of what they believe.
We talk to people a lot about the kingdom of Jesus, that the king has appeared, the first advent's happened, the cross is the central event in human history, but Jesus is going to return, and in this interim time where we live between the two advents, that we're advancing his kingdom, and we get to be part of the vanguard of God showing himself and his redemptive love to the whole world, and to especially the darkest corners of our world. And that's worth doing. That's something that's exciting.